21, get your first street cred. Make you feel like you a slime.
Well, being too aggressive.
Wow.
Like how Kiki Palmer said, Trey Songz didn't really rape her or do nothing to her. He was just so aggressive. And he still got a bad rap for it.
But Usher down there, fuck.
No, man.
Can't be too aggressive. Pressuring bitches into getting the pussy. That's what we used to do. You gonna give me the pussy? You gonna give me the pussy? No, you gonna give me the pussy?
Can I get it? We go together. Yeah. You know we go together.
Shit, that's how niggas grow up, trying to get pussy.
Bullshit.
I got my negotiation skills up.
Yeah, yeah.
I want to start this.
Everybody know about just put the tip in.
Oh, I was the king of that.
Yeah.
I was the king of that.
Let me just rub it against it.
Just the tip. Let me put the tip in. I'm good.
Tip or just a finger?
Mm-hmm.
I'm good.
Once you got the fang, you start sucking on the nipple. This
I get them nipples, I got you.
It's on pump.
I got
that's you. That's called coercing. You know, how you say that word?
Coerced into some pussy.
Coerced into the pussy. You're wrong.
You suck the nipple, you want me to do more than this.
Niggas like getting contracts. That bitch on a contract.
I got a stack for the waitress. I got a stack for security. And I got five for the bitch that I'ma fuck while she wearing my jewelry. And I got a couple hundred dollars for the nigga that parked my whip. And I got a lot more in my pocket. Somebody better stop it. That ain't shit. That's just tips. Try to take it, let that rocket bang. Classy Azul will stock the plane. Got the strip club looking like the stock exchange. You better watch your tone before that two-tone watch come and rock your homie. You are not the homie. Put a boulder on top of your molar and drive off. Now that's what I call a rock and roller. I am not for folding unless it's these bills. The code at the gate is a Netflix password. Come chill. You ain't never been in the Wisconsin mansion with a bitch you ain't live. Let me get some understanding. You just in here dancing on broke niggas for real? What? Ew. Shit. Well, let me get it jumping. I come from the slum, but I'm a slum dog millionaire. I show you how to get it bumping. Shit, you know I'm coming. Just as long as it ain't in your head. We gotta get it in something. Take that as straight facts, I ain't bluffing. I got a bread, got a pocket full of muffins. I gotta pay you back for your patience. But what if I said I got a stack for the waitress? I got a stack for security. And I got five for the bitch that I'ma fuck while she wearing my jewelry. And I got a couple hundred dollars for the nigga that parked my whip. And I got a lot more in my pocket. Somebody better stop it.
What it is.
That ain't shit. Man, that's just tips. That's just tips.
That's
just tips.
And I got a lot more in my pocket.
Whipping the viper, your shit don't hit you in the pit with the vipers. You gon' get beat cause you a clown ass nigga, so you won't get hit. I got a chain and another chain. Hop out the Lambo and get in another thing. I'm with the famo, ain't nobody struggling. Them niggas all a gang, I say other gang.
You know what I mean?
You gotta be honest, you know you're feeling it. So get on your knees and your diligence. I'm feeling it, isn't me, you're the fucking feeling this. Tell ass a hero to villain shit. I can't walk with a million. Blue face, hunters, they crippling. I know they don't like it, they're still getting it. Teddy pain is officially in the bitter bitch. Been with a fatty like a few times. Butter out the booty like a shoe shine. I'm about to murder this pussy. True crime. One thing by the shot, I'ma shoot mine. Pull it over, you too fine. Hit it back to back, that's two times. Open up your mouth, I gotta pay you back for your paycheck. Before I leave, I got a stack for the wages. I got a stack for security. And I got five for the bitch that I'ma fuck while she wearing my jewelry. And I got a couple hundred dollars for the nigga that parked my whip. And I got a lot more in my pocket. Somebody better stop it. That ain't shit. That's just.
And we back with another episode from the Gunshine State Podcast. I am your boy.
Come to find out, it's the 305.
Oh, and check it out. And I got one of the originals in the building, one of the originators of the Gunshine State Podcast. That boy just rolled in from Kansas. How he be, you know.
You already know, man. It's your boy Black, man. We in the fucking building, man.
See, that's for the people that's been with us for all 194 episodes where we first started. You know what I'm saying?
Hell yeah.
You six episodes from 200?
Six episodes from 200.
That's your next milestone.
600 from 200.
What? Don't worry about it.
Sixth episode from 200.
And I got a couple special guests in the building, man. I got your favorite podcast, homeboy.
You already know it is, man. Your boy, Young King Mo.
Hey, Tank, bring Domestic Violence back.
The family, the family.
Wait.
Bring Domestic Violence back.
You can just keep it moving, though.
Oh, you on your campaign right now?
Yeah.
As y'all can see, man, we having a dude cast in this bitch, you know what I'm saying? Key had to work, countdown, chilling with the family. Jazz doing her thing. And I got my brother in the building, you know what I'm saying? And I got my other brothers in this building, man. So we finna keep this thing moving, man. You know how it is, man.
Hey, yo.
How y'all week been, man? Whoever wanna start.
Got that thing oiled down.
How y'all week been?
Well, I'm talking about my car, man.
Oh, okay. You gotta say it a different way.
Yeah, how we been going?
You had that thing wore down. I was like, wait a minute.
What? I need to know what we talking about.
We been good. My wife was out of town, so I was out with this nigga last night. Kept the nigga up till like 4 a.m.
Out of time, my life.
God damn it, you know.
Oh, what y'all boy? Y'all was out here acting mixy. You niggas the mixy boys?
I don't know what that means, so I can't.
I can't comment on that.
Yeah, I can't even say that.
Y'all was in the mix.
I don't like that name, so no.
Somebody didn't say it right with me, so.
I don't like that name, so no.
Y'all was in the streets.
Y'all was in the mix last night.
Now, we all Eskimo brothers.
Oh, y'all had a real good time last night.
No,
huh?
No, I didn't say we became Eskimo brothers last night.
No. Ron would not fuck a bitch with me.
No.
He will not do it.
No, bro, I'm not doing it.
In the room. I don't understand. I think it's bonding. This is brotherly love. Yeah. Fuck a bitch together.
This nigga is crazy.
The thing
is,
you never did it. Every time I fucked a bitch with my homeboy or whatever, it was a party.
Mm. You, Mo, you did say you come to party, though.
I.
Oh, okay, I got
we
you.
We didn't come to party.
Okay.
I came to party.
What you put down.
You know what I'm saying? I can smoke a bag of that.
It was a point in time me and bro was fucking with the same bitch.
Oh,
yeah, man. Bro.
Well, we didn't do that at the same time, but we were fucking with the same.
Oh, man, in the girl.
I had them call her ass from... she was a player. She
gonna fuck the cool fucking.
Oh, yeah.
At first we didn't.
Nah, we did.
Yeah.
Shout out to her.
Yeah.
Oh, so she pulled the Usher and R. Kelly on y'all.
Yeah.
She pulled the same girl on you.
Yeah.
But I started calling a bit from his phone. Then he started calling a bit from my phone.
Now she don't know what the fuck going on.
She don't know what the fuck was going on. I told her pull up. You know, he was right there.
Yeah. Eskimo brothers. Y'all Eskimo brothers. Like, man, this nigga here. Find it.
Toss it up.
Yeah, man.
So y'all night last night, how you... Which I was out at 4 a.m.
We went to D's Lounge.
Oh, you did say y'all was going to go out there.
That's the new little hangout spot for us. You know what I'm saying?
What is that?
Oh, right now.
Evergreen?
Yeah.
Evergreen.
Right out Florida Ave.
Shut side.
Hey, that nigga.
That's it. Right out Florida Ave.
Wait a minute.
Why you did that, bro?
Gotta let him know. Don't let nigga driving to be like, where the am I going? Yeah, that's all.
We went to Mr. D's. Mr. D's. That's an old club I used to go to. We went to D's Lounge. Then we ended up going to the Loft. Then we went over there. Shout out to, I told you I was going to do it. Shout out to Bad Chick Chicken and Waffle. You can catch it every Friday and Saturday across the street from
the Loft.
The Loft. Good ass chicken. Good ass fries. Even if, bro, you know you got a good food truck when the French fries good, bro. Like, them bitches was delicious. Like, chicken wings.
You was high.
Nah, not really. Not really. It was pretty good.
Seasoning and all that type of
shit. Bro, that's why I said they were so good. They was cooked. Like, oh, man.
What type
bro.
Of fries? The waffle fries?
The crinkle fries.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, them bitches was good. Shrimp, big Mayport shrimp.
My wife back in town now, so I'm going to be rushing home to go fuck shit out of. I was fucking with the hoes last night. Didn't really see nothing particular that was worth bringing. You got to make up for lost time.
All right, Black, how your week been, bro?
Man. My week was good, man. My daughter just graduated and shit. You know what I mean?
Oh, let me get some applause.
What's up?
Yeah, little bird, you know what I mean? Yeah, she definitely just graduated, man. I'm fucking road tearing my ass up. Just coming from Washington, coming from with the Illinois for a minute. Then that was Iowa for a minute. That was in Cali for a minute. But that road has just been crazy. But other than that, that shit all right.
What's the craziest thing you done seen on the road so far since you done been? With this trip, with this company and stuff.
White people fighting at the gas station. They was at the gas station.
Fucking hoodlums.
Yeah, they was at the fucking gas station fighting. One dude was up there waiting at a pump too damn long. He came and he was up there to my, bro, you need to move. Nigga said, man, I'm taking my break, man. Nigga said, not right here. Nigga said, you know, nigga that swung on him. I'm like, oh, man, I couldn't pull my phone out fast enough.
Oh, yeah. Niggas is wildin'.
These niggas wildin', yeah, man.
Niggas is wildin'.
That's a no-no for the truck drivers. But, hey, tell the niggas that all the lot lizards don't look like trash. Sometimes... Them lot
lizards. You can't
lizards,
see, can't you, man? That's Brittany.
Them lot lizards, man. Stay away from the lot lizards because they go from truck to truck. But no, they do. You're right, though.
Well, them lizards,
some of them be bad.
Them lizards, I've never seen a bad lot lizard. Okay, I'm going to go on record and say that.
You don't know. Yeah,
but see, I don't be at the truck stop.
Yeah, you go to the Flying J at the right time. But
oh, yeah. You at the pilot.
Hello, Brittany. With all that.
What's up, Brittany? We're talking about lot lizards.
Oh. You know what a lot lizard is, Brittany?
Absolutely.
Of course you do.
You just took the cameraman seat.
You took the cameraman seat, but
yeah, but them lot lizards, man, they stay away from them, man. You don't want to deal with none of them lot lizards, man.
Wow. All
right, that's his recommendation.
But you love it. you for the lot lizards,
huh?
Listen.
Because they knock on your door real quick. They be in a coop, 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 coop. You want a party?
Be safe.
You goddamn right. Well, no, I've never seen an attractive lot lizard, so I can't say that.
Yeah, you ain't on that road, but
that's what I'm saying. I'm pretty sure there's some bad ones out there. But the ones I have seen,
I can't fuck with them though. I just be spooked because they be going from truck to truck, and some of them niggas be like, "Ooh, how you deal with that motherfucker?" Then my truck, nah.
Yeah,
I'm good.
Yeah, okay. Now you got a point.
Yeah, I'd be good because them motherfuckers
catch them at the beginning of the night. Beginning of the stroll.
Yeah, yeah. If you catch me,
if you one of the first
fresh out the block, yeah.
You don't want to be there at 4 o'clock in the morning and she come knocking.
Because she done already been through the journey.
Oh, yeah.
The journey has begun.
Be looking terrible out there. Terrible.
Yeah, you'll be like, you just suck anything. Huh?
Yeah, exactly.
Anything in your mouth. Nasty bitch.
Fuck is wrong with you?
What's the best?
I love thugging out your podcast.
What's the best? What's the best gas station to pick up a lot lizard at?
Route 66.
Why in my mind I'm thinking pilot? I don't know why.
I'm thinking pilot too.
Route 66. Look, because it got a big.
This nigga got the answer. Hey, he sitting there like, let me let him cool.
Driver. He on the road. So he know.
Yeah. Okay.
He know.
Or the Flying J.
Yeah,
the Flying J.
They got showers in there.
All of them got showers in there.
Okay.
Don't go to the TA showers. Them shits like, yeah.
Would Buc-ee's be considered?
No.
No trucks allowed at Buc-ee's.
No. They will come get your ass towed.
Oh, so you can't even spend the night overnight?
Hell no. What? You can park your shit on the outside, but it can't be on that property, though.
Damn.
Oh, yeah. They.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, they wow. I've never noticed. I've never seen a truck.
Yeah, and why they so strict? Why you like? Why you scared of them niggas, man? Fuck them niggas.
Yeah.
That nigga said the niggas dope niggas.
Truck drivers doing fucked up shit.
Yeah. They doing all type of shit out there, man. They fucking up the property and all. You got piss bottles all over the place and shit like that. Yeah. Truck drivers don't give a fuck. They will fuck that shit up.
Truck drivers of America.
Yeah, they don't play with your shit, man.
Mo, how you been?
That week was good, man. Both of my boys graduated.
Oh, that's what I'm talking about.
Niggas ain't graduate. I'm joking. I'm just hating right now.
He hating, bro.
I'm just doing my podcast shit right now.
He hating, bro.
I don't mean no harm, bro.
You don't want to be here that 2 weeks in a row?
Yeah. I'm chilling, bro. I'm not yelling this podcast.
Oh, they were going in on you last week.
I'm not yelling this show.
You told me that shit. That
when I get this monotone voice, that means everything
is cool.
That's peace.
I can understand. I can dig that, bro.
This is only a character. You know what I'm saying? So I'm finna flip the switch back on. Man, them niggas ain't motherfucking graduated.
My boys graduated. I hung out with Tank Ass.
Two shots for the boys.
I got Brittany Big Boot Ass in the building. We probably finna try to start a sports podcast or something.
Bring it on a little
bit. The boys
he
graduated from high school, middle school, or what?
Probably his pros more than.
You said they graduated from what?
I thought you said we're going to talk. No. One went from 56, one went from 3rd to 4th.
Okay.
That was crazy. I thought he said, I'm, like, we talking about pro sports because we started.
No, I got you. Man. But you said from 56, from third to fourth.
Yeah, 56.
So they got promoted.
Graduated.
56 count, because that's like going from elementary to middle
school. Them boys made it to the next level. Fuck with them.
Niggas hate them, bro.
Yeah, yeah. Niggas, don't worry about it.
If you hate on children, that's what is a problem, bro. When you start hating on the lads. That's wild, bro. That was wild.
Ask them what they want to be. And if they say a giraffe, kick it out of the
house. Stop doing that, bro. Stop doing that, bro.
I'm just finishing up Charlemagne book. Shouts out Charlemagne. His newest book, Small Talk Sucks. But anyways.
Bro, you laughed at me when I was reading 50 Cent book.
Hey, yo, bro.
That 50 Cent book was live.
The nigga laughed at me, bro.
No, I like it. I'm good. Go ahead.
Nigga laughed at me, bro.
We ain't talking about 50 Cent, bro. We talking about Charlamagne.
That 50 Cent book was live.
Shit was good as fuck.
Yeah, that shit was good. I got a lot of pointers from that.
He was talking about how you should not. It's called the astronaut theory. You know what I'm saying? Okay. If your kids want to come up and say, man, I want to be an astronaut. You shouldn't say, well, it's only such and such many astronauts. You might want to talk about being something
practical. My daughter going to college for that right now.
You know what I'm saying? You might well say, yeah, well, fuck it. If they say come to you and say, I want to be an astronaut, you might well say, okay, well, what planet you want to go to?
So if your daughter... tell their kids, you ain't going to be no astronaut. Who the hell does that?
So, but what I'm saying is, if your daughter comes up to you and says she wants to be a giraffe...
What should I do?
Please explain this shit.
What the nigga in the book said I should do? Get along with it. Grow your neck.
Hey, polka dot. I said shit.
Color your shirt yourself, bitch. You
fuck out of here.
Start hanging her food up high so she can cook it.
Yeah,
that's what you need to do right now, man. Yeah,
no, bro.
Start making all that nigga did was depress me.
That nigga, and it didn't make it no better that Janae's daughter had just said that she wanted to be an astrophysicist or some shit, bro. Some shit she said. And then she said she wanted to be a giraffe. That was crazy.
Fucking giraffe.
Oh, man. Okay, we can start. We didn't get a chance to get into the Diddy shit last week.
Five, why was your week, Five?
Oh, shit. Oh, damn. You know what? My week has been great. Good. New supervisor at the job. I'm writing niggas up all
every
day. You know what I'm saying?
We on our Charleston White this year.
I'm averaging one write up a day.
Ooh.
You know what I'm saying?
Y'all niggas better watch your ass, boy.
My boy averaging a single on their ass. Hey,
the niggas at the nigga warehouse, it's a lot of them offices with trash cans and
steal them.
Steal them.
Okay.
Steal them shit. Put them in your car.
Please, and then, nigga, if you try to walk on this floor 3 minutes late, I gotta get you, bro.
Break is over at 6:30. Not so at 6:23, you need to be washing up your dishes.
Yeah, I need walk time.
Walk time. Okay, it takes two.
Back and forth.
Exactly. Break it down to him, bro. Break it down to his ass, Five.
Okay,
break this shit down.
You get the break room way over there.
Okay.
You get a 15-minute break, right?
Okay.
Okay. That's really 20.
No, it's not. Because
it really is. I agree, man.
So no, you get a 15-minute break. It takes 2.5 minutes to walk from anywhere in the warehouse to each break room.
That's 5 minutes.
If you're walking with some sense of urgency, it's gonna take you 2.5 minutes to get to where you need to get to.
This real supervisor talk here, nigga.
For your break. Now you take 2.5 minutes to get back. That's 5 minutes there. So you really only got a 10-minute break.
Okay.
So if our break starts at 6:15. At 6:25-ish, you need to be getting up, getting your stuff.
So you really only got like a 7-minute break.
So by the time 6:30 hit, I need to see you walking to the floor.
No, that's bullshit, though.
Okay.
No problem.
I'm just saying,
though. I need to step into my office after break. Sitting down right there.
Okay.
My whole 30 minutes, I'd be from 6 o'clock to 6:30. That's when I need to sit right here.
Okay.
At 6:29, I look up, boom.
Step into my office after this break.
Why?
Because
I did my 30 minutes right here, bro.
Just slide the paperwork.
This is some bullshit.
It is. But listen, here's the thing. I'm fair.
Okay.
And if you don't like what I'm doing, you can report that to my supervisor.
And they'll handle it from there.
And listen, I won't have no problem with that. You know what I'm saying?
Matter of fact, you don't even got
to
sign it.
You don't have to sign it.
I'm not signing
it. That's cool.
I'm not signing it.
That's cool, bro. But I'm just letting people know that we had this conversation.
Do what Charleston White do. All right? Look for safety.
Sue their ass.
Look for safety shit. Complain.
Oh, yeah.
And then when it don't get fixed.
Sue their ass.
And then they fire you for complaining. Sue them.
Have you terminated anybody?
No. I ain't terminated anybody.
Your first termination?
Oh, wow. Now, that was crazy.
I like how you talking. No problem. Ready to fire a nigga.
That's some bullshit.
That's some bullshit.
That's some bullshit.
That's why I get off the train.
That's why I get, bro.
I love, well, I'm on the other side.
You did it to yourself. You did it to yourself.
What you taking my 30 minutes just to get me? So I gotta cut my 30 minutes.
Me, bitch.
Y'all missed
on time to be at my post.
So listen, bro, I was always taught when you early, you're on time. When you're on time, you late.
Man, fuck that. I'm taking that.
Okay, well, no problem.
You gave me 30 minutes, though, man.
No, okay.
I gave you 30 minutes to get there and back in 30 minutes.
No.
I didn't give you 30 minutes plus an additional 10.
That's what I'm talking about.
No. But I didn't give you that, though, Black.
No. You don't take your 15 minutes and then go to the bathroom.
Yeah, bro. No, you go to the bathroom on your 2.5-minute walk to the front. That's when you go to the bathroom.
No.
You never take a bathroom, go to the bathroom off the clock.
What, no,
the
hell no.
Hell no. You always go
off the clock. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. No, these niggas should be. But here,
you got to be out your mind.
I'm on the clock going to, I be back.
Yeah, I'll be like right back.
10 minutes, 15 minutes, yeah.
Shouts out to my new supervisor, you know what I'm saying? He taught me the new verbiage. After I write you up, it's no problem.
It's okay.
You can report this to my supervisor and or HR, and I don't take no offense to that, bro. Mm. We still cool.
Ryan, you ever signed a write-up? I don't think I ever signed a write-up.
I don't sign write-ups.
Why? I did probably when I was 18 at Walmart.
Once I understood that, I don't have to sign that. No, I'm not signing.
Fuck you, ain't
I've slid them back.
Yeah, man.
Literally.
Matter of fact, don't even call me for this shit no more. Just write me up.
Just write it up and whoever. Put it in the file cabinet like you going to do.
If I fire, no.
All right, then. Yeah. What the fuck is this? We wasting trees.
Yeah. Once you tell me, like, you can't sign it, you don't have to sign it. I'm like, I don't have to sign it? Oh, no. Yeah. Why would I sign it? After you told me
I don't agree with it.
Yeah. Refuse to sign. I can put refuse. I'm gonna put refuse to sign.
Let me know when I can't still no stem that. You refuse to sign it.
Yeah, I refuse. I definitely refuse to sign it. And why did you refuse to sign it? Because I don't agree with it. That's just like me going to sign documents for something and that I don't agree with. No, I'm not signing.
So have you ever been written up for something that you know you did and you just still ain't signing it?
You fucking right. What are we talking about? Nigga, you never say I'm guilty. What are we talking? Did we learn nothing from OJ? Nah. What are you talking about?
When I worked at Sears, the warehouse.
I signed that shit.
When I worked at Sears warehouse, they had a metal detector. And you had to walk through it. I was stealing so much shit. And they knew it was me. But they couldn't prove it. I had the big boots. And this was when navigational system that just came out, the garments. I put the shit in my boot, while right at that bit, ding, ding, ding. What, man? He's still told. What the fuck? What you want me to do? God damn it. Take my shoes off? All right, take my shoes off. But it's in my socks, so you can't.
Exactly.
You still can't tell. They were like, I told this nigga doing something.
Cause I can't, you can't maybe take my socks off, man.
Shouts out football fanatic, nigga. I used to be going crazy.
Oh, you used to go hit the ass across the head from where I remember.
Crazy, nigga. Anyways, back. Mm-hmm. My week has been great. I don't think the statute of limitations.
All right. Get into some topics.
Yeah, like I say, man. On my show, we didn't get a chance to touch on the Diddy shit, man. Mm-hmm. I need them views, man.
That boy Diddy, boy. That boy something serious. What y'all feel about his apology?
Nobody don't want to go first. Huh? I see everybody trying to. Everybody trying to. Because Black with his politically correct ass answer, he just came with. I'm gonna say a little bit, but then I'm gonna be like, so what you think?
Okay, so what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna set the scene, boom. The video came out.
Bro, we seen the video. You don't have to say no scene, bro. So now you trying to have some input to say, oh, I see something. No, we saw the video. He kicked the bitch in the ass, drug her down the steps. Yeah. He did the worst thing you could do to her. He treated her really wrong. It was wrong what he did. Did it? You just fucked up.
Oh, I thought it was.
There was no secret. Cassie gave the tape to CNN.
No, there's some people out here still trying to wonder how the tape got leaked.
Because I was wondering, too, because I thought the shit just dropped.
That's what I'm saying. If he had a copy, she had a copy. Now we know.
CNN up until the tape.
That means she gave them.
CNN. This ain't TMZ. This CNN, nigga.
Just official news.
Just a week before the tape came out, he was like, these allegations is false. Everything they're saying against
Stevie J out here wanting to fight niggas and shit.
Yeah. And then the tape come out. Oh, you been a piece of shit the whole time.
And now everybody want to distance themselves. See, I'm not like the shit Lil Scrappy did. I can't respect that. Because now you want to come out and be super aggressive, super mad. You want to fight Diddy and all this. But, bro, you probably done been in 3-4 of them parties, seen him do all that different type shit you seen. You probably done seen all of that. But now for the camera and the gram, you want to come on, bro. Just shut the fuck up. Just unfollow him like everybody else doing. Just shut the fuck up.
I hear that. Do you accept PD apology, though?
No, because it was bullshit. Mm. You didn't hold no accountability into it. Like, it was bullshit.
Okay, yeah, until the tape came out. Some bullshit. You want to apologize for the shit. I'm picking up with you.
It was no accountability held in that.
No real friends in this industry.
Oh, hell no. Yeah. It's all cutthroat. Dog eat dog.
If I see you beating a bitch or whatever, I'm going to say that's fucked up. But you still my nigga.
Mm-hmm.
Like Usher, Dre, all these niggas that were always around him. If you see the video, you can't be like, nah, I'm going to diss myself. If that's your nigga, you be like, hey, my nigga fucked up.
Yeah.
I didn't know he was doing it to this extent, but I love my nigga that's still my nigga.
We're going
to
get him some help.
Them niggas is getting the fuck away from him.
We're going to get him some help.
Yeah, I'm picking it up.
Now it's like, oh, let me just get the fuck away from him.
Yeah, and I don't respect that.
Steph Curry unfollowed him. LeBron. Young Miami. Just for unfollowing.
Only thing my nigga could do that'll fuck me up is if he fuck with kids.
Yeah, I got to get away from you on that. Or don't take care of your kids.
Outside of fucking with kids, if you beat a bitch and you my nigga,
Beat the bitch in front of me, though, because you put me in an awkward spot.
We're going to have some. I agree with that.
Nah, for it. Nah, like, if any of y'all, if I walk out the door right now, and I know you wouldn't, but you out there beating on your wife. Hey, 305, don't beat on her.
Yeah.
Until you get home.
I'm breaking it up.
All right.
Keep that shit in your own space.
Hey, y'all breaking that shit up out here, man. Did y'all see Cameron on CNN?
I love it.
No, I ain't getting
it. I love
that hotel.
Get a story. What do you do?
Minors.
Going to get some chicks out there.
Domestic violence. I'm totally against it.
He was talking.
So when I seen the video, yeah, I was kind of upset with it. No, being that I know him, he's not necessarily a friend, but yeah, I was upset when I seen it. But
did you recognize
everything
him?
I just said.
Did you recognize that kind of anger at all from your experiences?
I don't know him like that. What did you mean? Did I recognize him? I seen him. What do you mean my experiences? I seen him and I thought it was disgusting. I didn't do a zoom in to see if it was really him or nothing, but he admitted it was him, so.
Okay.
Yeah, she's asking
about PD. What did you think about the apology that he gave in that other video?
Amy, for this, the apology ain't for me, it decides for Cassie. What I think about it don't matter. He ain't do nothing to me. Cassie need to ask Cassie if she accept the apology. I told you how I feel. I said what I said.
I want to play a conversation that you had on your podcast.
Man, it's almost going to bring me to tears to say this. I just,
you can see Cam is trying to be diplomatic.
Is
there something known in the industry about how Diddy treated his artists?
Get some cheeks after this.
So I'm going to get some cheeks after this horsepower joint.
My nigga.
This nigga,
I'm just going off what Mace said. Mace took me to Biggie. I don't really know Puffers. Like, Mace know Puff. So I appreciate what Mace said. And, of course, that's my brother. So if he felt that way, then he felt that way. I can't really tell you how Puff moves or anything like that. Mace may know better than me because he was signed to Puff.
He died.
But my show does come on at 8 a.m. Eastern on YouTube. It's called It Is What It Is.
Y'all check it out.
I mean, I might get some more information out of Mace from there, but for me to tell you...
I'm telling you who we'll talk to.
And all that, I don't know. I never was signed to him.
Yeah. What about the industry in general? I mean, so many people have pointed out that Diddy couldn't get away with this stuff if there weren't a lot of people protecting him. Do you think that's the case?
I mean, yeah, they good questions, but at the wrong time. Wrong person.
Who the talent agent for this joint? Like,
that's why I say good questions. Wrong person.
Diddy doing all this? I didn't know this was a Diddy joint that I was inviting me to. Yeah, who?
Y'all,
who
moved me for this joint? Diddy joint.
All right. I'll be Cameron.
Cameron.
Yeah.
Thanks for joining. Yes.
It was the Cameron for me.
I will say though that
Cameron.
They love to antagonize people.
I will say the black lady handled that professionally. So shout out to her.
I think Cam handled that professionally too.
Yeah, but I don't,
Cam went into Cam.
Exactly.
No, Cam could have really went the fuck in.
But yeah, I think he did Cam. He did the Cam he is now.
The black lady had a corporate job. She just trying to do her job. I think she didn't.
There you go.
Well, what kind of?
It's the same microphones you use on your podcast, bro.
Yeah. I think she was just trying to do a job. So she, I don't think she did too much. She was only doing what the fucking network wanted her to do.
Nah, I think she was pushing a little too much because you could see he was disengaged about it.
What you here for, nigga?
No, that's not what it seemed like, though.
He's like, he got caught off guard. Like, what
yeah, that's what I'm like, saying. It seemed like that's not what you hit me up to ask me about it. Maybe you hit me up.
She ain't hit him up. She just, somebody hit him up. It wasn't her, though.
Well, then it seemed like the network
was something different.
Yeah, the network dropped her into a fucked up situation.
Next person they get on, you just need to be like, hey, nigga, what you saw?
They need to get one of us on there.
Well, we ain't seen nothing. Get one of these niggas that saw something on there. But, hey, what the nigga was doing?
Fucking them hoes and them niggas.
Tell me something.
I seen them do it.
Mm-hmm.
Who he beat?
He spared her.
Tupac and Biggie.
Well.
Because now that the nigga been lying, you don't know what the nigga been lying about.
That's the other thing about this shit. Like, you, even when somebody come out with that shit now, you got to believe it.
Because now two shootings, he's been linked to being the person with the one in the studio and then the one in the club with J-Lo.
J-Lo tried to warn you niggas.
No, like, that black lady, she told us a long time ago. She said, I seen him do it. It was him.
Jaguar,
oh,
right.
Yeah. No.
And they buried her. But it was like, she was like, nah, it was him. He did it.
And that nigga shot somebody else in the arm, like had a little party. He shot a nigga in the stomach.
In the studio shit, when they went in the bathroom. Him and his son.
Exactly.
Him, his son, and his son friend went in the bathroom. Bro got shot. But they took him outside in the back and reported it as if it happened outside the studio.
Mm-hmm.
He paid the police for that. I mean, it was in the 75 page.
What to do as a boss.
So
all right.
What kind of boss are you? What the fuck are we talking about?
A fucked up boss. That's what bosses is.
You sound like El Chapo.
You know what you got to do to be a boss? To move up the ladder, you got to be ruthless. So we can't expect these niggas to be angels. Yes, I had to shoot
this
nigga.
But I didn't expect Diddy to be Suge Knight.
Shit. That's a facade that he put up. I got to slap this nigga. I got to beat this bitch.
Take that.
That's
how I know Diddy.
I got to have that maniac personality. Yeah,
you do got to do it because when you watch Empire, it tell you got to be like that. You got to be like a dragon out here.
That shit's wild.
Trump is a savage. You think you get to where Trump at without being a savage?
Nah, not at all.
All right, so we're going to pass right by.
He tried to get past that shit quick, dog.
LeBron James, Charles Barkley, they getting backlash for defending Caitlin Clark.
About the charter flights and all that shit.
Let's shut it up.
So first, let me let y'all hear what LeBron had to say about Caitlin.
Dog
Stace.
That I love that she's bringing to her sport, more people want to watch.
True.
More people want to tune in. Don't get it twisted. Don't get it fucked up. Caitlin Clark is the reason why a lot of great things is going to happen for the WNBA.
Where you lie?
But for her individually, I don't think she should get involved on nothing that's being said. Just go have fun, enjoy, you know. But I'm rooting for Caitlin because I've been in that seat before. I've walked that road before. I hope she kills. I hope Aaliyah Boston does amazing.
Got disgusted.
You know, I hope they do great. You know, I'm just kind of in this mode right now because I'm getting the same, you know, thing from watching my son, who's a 19-year-old, kind of getting a lot of animosity and hatred towards him when he's just a kid trying to live out his dream. You know, there's a very small number of women out here doing whatever.
Yeah. What'd he say wrong?
Angela Reese won a championship, right? Angel Reese, yeah. She won. Did Caitlin win a?
No.
She didn't, right?
No. Okay.
I have no idea why the spotlight is on Caitlin Clark.
She white.
What the fuck are we talking about?
In college, she was a good
baller.
She's a great baller.
She was a good, great baller in college. Angel
no,
Reese
she's not.
Was the nigga on her team, and they won a ship. I have no idea why they giving the
Angel
torch.
Reese is a great player.
She ain't Caitlin Clark.
She ain't Caitlin Clark.
What is it about Caitlin Clark I'm missing?
Do you watch the game?
She's the Steph Curry of the of them females.
She real deal can.
See, this is why LeBron like her, because it's just like LeBron and Jordan.
Here's the thing.
Jordan won the ship. And niggas give LeBron praise just because he got there. Caitlin Clark didn't win no fucking ship. She got there. So that's why LeBron like
him. So here's the thing, though. They went just as hard. They went just as hard for Angel.
Not about Jordan.
They went just as hard for Angel Reese as they do for Caitlin Clark. Angel Reese was getting backlash for being outlandish and a female how she is.
Angel Reese got the same thing.
You got Shaq and everybody that was defending her. So it's not like because she's white. They get the same amount of support.
I just don't get what are they defending her against.
But my thing is, y'all showed me one clip.
So did you not just did Angel Reese not get the same get hella support when she was doing the shit in her face? No, and
you can't guard me.
She got backlash.
But
no. The first year when the white girl was doing this, the second year when she came back and
she got backlash, but the people, us, came to support her for the backlash that she was getting from the people.
The white folks were not.
We're not talking about the white folks. We're talking about people like Shaquille O'Neal, people like the LeBron Jameses.
Supported Caitlin, and then LeBron supported Caitlin. Angel didn't get that. She got it from the us, but she didn't get it from the celebrities. Let's not do that.
The average WA
That's not what we're talking about, though.
What are we talking about?
That's not what we're talking about. I'm talking about the amount of support.
Why are we acting like the white girl can't hoop? That's my thing, though. Why are we acting like she actually can't hoop?
Well, she can hoop. She definitely can ball.
Because she can actually hoop.
I guess my question is,
so just because she didn't win a college championship, doesn't mean she can't transition and be great?
You got to win. You LeBron niggas, well, y'all love a non-winner.
No, I'm saying so.
You got to win the ship.
No. All right. So just because she didn't win a college championship.
Bring it back.
Let's just say she wins a title this year. Let's say she knock off the Aces and she wins the title this year. Then what?
You earned it.
I'm just asking.
Then you earned it. Then you earned the praise.
But let's not act like we don't
dingle for the college championship if she wins.
So let's not
NBA championship.
LeBron James was still good, but guess what?
Let's not act like
until he actually got the fucking ring with Miami.
Let's not act like the Indiana Fever.
The Indiana Fever what?
LeBron James had him in the four of us.
LeBron, what?
Let's
not act like the Indiana. Let's not act like the Indiana Fever is the capital A team in the league now. Like,
but y'all was also making it seem like Caitlin Clark going to the Indiana Fever was going to be that.
Nobody said that.
I just had this conversation.
Nobody said that. Said she was going to change the league. As she has, but the team is a number one pick twice.
I think
Caitlin Clark is on the sucky team, right?
But since she's been on the team, what have her numbers looked like compared to Angel Reese being on her team? And look at Angel Reese numbers.
We're talking about a team sport.
I have a question.
Correct?
Sir, I'm saying sports.
Okay, so.
I know.
The team, okay.
I get it.
So follow me then. The team has the losing record.
Understand.
The past 2 years.
Understand.
Angel Reese team has not has the okay, so that.
You don't
got to
talk to me like I know
you. Because. The point wasn't made because I didn't finish speaking. The point wasn't made because I didn't finish speaking.
Go ahead.
So the point is, Angel Reese's team is inherently better because they had the better ski. She had the better squad. So Caitlin Clark.
Angel Reese averaged less than Caitlin Clark. Caitlin Clark averaged 15 points. Angel Reese averaged 12.
What about the rest of them?
I'm just saying.
Angel Reese is 12-8. She's 12-8.
I'm just saying.
Angel Reese getting 12-8 every night.
I got a question. Can I ask a question? When they're talking about Caitlin Clark.
Good way to bring it back. I like how you did that. He settled the room. That boy good. Hold on, we almost done.
When you're talking about Caitlin Clark and everybody, when LeBron is defending them and Chuck is defending them, I get confused because it's like, who are you defending her against? Because, she's getting back. So when they be like the haters and this person and that person, I be like, well, what do y'all want? What do you? I don't see the hate.
Yo. Yeah, I don't see the hate. That's what.
Yeah, all I see is good competition. I see her competing, playing as hard as she can to try to win. I see Angel Reese doing the same thing.
Caitlin Clark has played more minutes on average, 31.4. Reese has 27.7. With a better field goal percentage, 40.3 to 33.3. A better free throw percentage, 91.3 to 58.3. A better three-pointed percentage, 32.6 to 0% for Reese.
Now you know what the comments going to say?
So now I just showed you.
You ain't black women, bro.
That Caitlin Clark,
black women, bro.
Statistically, is better than Angel Reese. It says it right here.
You can't do that.
She averages more minutes, and she's better than several key categories.
Wait, we're missing the point. The point is,
so why wouldn't she get the most?
No, she's better than Angel Reese, but they both trash right now.
They on trash teams.
No. They're play. Angel Reese and Caitlin Clark's numbers are trash right now.
But we comparing the two. But I'm comparing the two of those.
I know, but this is what I'm saying. Caitlin Clark is averaging what, 13 points? 15? Angel Reese is averaging like 15. What, 12?
15.
12 and 8. A strong 12 and 8.
That's not strong as the top WNBA players. So what I'm saying is, we are acting like they are carrying. Listen, we need to give them time to develop. Both of them are young. Let them develop.
But my only argument is, Brittany was making it like when me and him said Caitlin Clark better. No, the fuck she not. Well, statistically, Caitlin Clark. Caitlin Clark is leading right now.
Wait, I'm out for that because statistics is trash.
She's leading. Now what you're going to do is take the team record and be like, well, her team better than her. I'm talking about them as individual players. Caitlin Clark,
the team matters, though.
Statistically, Angel Reese is 0% from the three.
They're the same, bro. Okay. Neither one better. They're the same.
She's 91.3% from the free throw.
Both of these bitches like that.
I do agree with you.
That's all I'm saying. I'm not saying Angel Reese can't hoop.
They avoided the studs and the dice and both of them like this. I applaud it. I love it. Now, they might eat some. Caitlin Clark. She looked like Caitlin Clark looked like a nigga. She might eat some pussy on the side. But
she's married, ain't she?
Is she married? Caitlin Clark.
No, she got a boyfriend.
She got a boyfriend.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah. Well, he's a nice looking young man.
I'll tell you, yeah,
college days. She eat pussy on the side.
A regular college looking nigga.
Caitlin Clark look like a nigga.
So are we saying it's overrated right now? No. Is that what we saying? So what are we actually saying?
I think it's working. I think
to the sport of WNBA because they're putting it in the spotlight to get them more publicity.
But we can. It can only be one Neo.
I like both of them.
They pick the white girl. You know what I'm saying? Let the white girl get the exposure. Let her get people to come in. Let her do it.
That's like what Jeff Teague said.
Let her do it.
Think about this.
That's like what Jeff Teague said. So it's working.
So I like what she's doing as far as what.
So let it cook. Let it cook. Let her.
So
if everybody coming just to see this white girl, coming to see this white girl, you're going to also see the other team she's playing against.
Yeah.
So now that might make you a fan of this other team when you came to see her. So, like, just let her cook. Let her cook. That's what I'm saying. I don't like, I think because she's a white girl, they like, well, yeah, she white. Let her cook. Let her bring spotlight to it. Let her do it. Let her do it.
Pass the ball.
They got their TV deal trying to get ready to come on.
Pass the ball. Let her cook. God damn. Pass the fucking ball.
That's a rap basketball.
Pass the ball. God damn. Pass the fucking ball.
I don't know. That shit just weird to me. WNBA is in a good spot. That shit is rising, bro.
Pass the ball. Oh, my God. God damn. Pass the fucking ball. Pass the fucking. Hey. All right.
Real. With the bitches in booty shorts. I watch every game. Faithfully. What's up, 305? 305 been trying to say something for the past 10, 15 minutes.
No, it's okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and cut y'all off on the YouTube. Make sure y'all like, comment, subscribe on everything that we doing. Y'all going to have to start calling me Mr. 40K around in a bit. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, Miss Brittany, I ain't mean no harm. I just like to turn the character on.
Cuss out. It make a pussy
so, if y'all want to hear our before air banter and our songs of the week, make sure y'all go to our Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, everywhere you get your podcasts. This is the Gunshine State Podcast. Bah! Song of the week. Let's get the song of the week.